Hey folks, Rob back with another C64 gameplay. This time it's a look at the Hewson Classic Zynaps. I had to do the run of this. I've had it in the collection for a while, and in fact, after being at PAX a few days before I'm recording this, I had to quickly add the Spectrum on again so I can remember that it's quite a good blaster. So, originally, as I understand it, it was a great article in Retro Gamer a few months ago talking about the development, and it was intended to be a joint lead on Spectrum and C64. But was revised a bit, but the Spectrum version ended up being the lead, and that was put together by Dominic Robinson, who was probably best known for doing the Spectrum conversion of Iridium, which a lot of people thought was impossible, and he actually did a rather good job of it. So you can sort of see he's got a lot of the fairly good talent behind it, so we'll dive in and play how it goes. The basic storyline is that you're piloting a fighter that's escaping out of an enemy, you know, stronghold, and you're sort of making your way to their main stronghold. And one of the things that's unique with it is simply its power-up system. But yeah, standard fair horizontal blaster. And the way you get pickups is you fly over them, and then you have to use your scoop, which you hold down a button, hence why I'm flashing, and ramp into a pickup. So at the moment, we've just been grabbing the speed pickup, which is not a good idea. So right now, if I were to collect a power-up with the scoop on, I'd get a speed upgrade, which I don't want. But I do want a weapon upgrade. So you can upgrade your lasers a number of times. You can and also get missiles. So as you can see, there's, you know, fairly nice... I'm utterly terrible at this game, it should be said, which is a shame, because it's a rather good one. But at the same time, yeah, I'm not a fan. I like the power-up system is what took me a long time to get used to. And it wasn't until I actually got a copy that I could say, oh, that's what it's doing. And understand why it worked the way it does. I mean, I guess I'm a big fan of power-up systems that are actually a lot more straightforward. And as you can see, already got game over. Let's try again and see if I don't screw it up. I mean, you can see what they've done with the power-ups. It's really to mimic the way a game like Gradius works, but the thing with Gradius, of course, is that the power-ups were text, so you could read that you exactly what system you do have, and I think that doesn't really work here. I wish it would as like a text indicator for what you would get when you next activated the power-up, but that's a personal preference. Seems to be doing okay now, so I might keep my mouth quiet while I... Ooh, curses. Doing much better though. But unfortunately, it's another bugbear. Start of the stage. It's a personal thing, but I'm not a fan of being sent back to the start of the stage when you die. But I can probably see it's a case of, well, losing all of the power-ups. See if we get the boss again. Memory serves, I haven't defeated it in playing, so... Ah, curses. Not a good... See, tech-wise, I can see why this was more regarded on the Spectrum, because it would have been an absolute push for the hardware to get it to play as well as it does. Whereas here on the 64, when you've got much more capable hardware, you know, it's sort of doing what it does best. But in terms of checking out, I certainly think you should. It is feeling really frantic and really well put together. I mean, I'm rubbish at it, to be honest, but I am enjoying it. And after, well, an incredibly busy week, which hopefully you've seen the video I posted on that, it's good to chill out a fairly mindless kind of game for once. Yes, Last Life. Ah, curses. Well, that's another game over. Oh, we got in. We got in the list. All right. Let's go for another play after this. Question is, how far on the Roll of Honor did I get? Have to see. Then we'll dive in one more play. I want to see if I can at least get to that end level boss again. Not spectacular, but not terrible. And I do have to laugh that the high score was 68,000. Silly move. Silly move there. Oh, nice bouncing bombs. And then go and spoil it over doing something silly like crashing into a wall. So meanwhile we've gone through, what do I think about presentation? Presentation is pretty solid. Controls are built tight. It's nice. I'm still half and half on whether I like the physics, having physics in the, having sort of the physics and inertia to your movement. I mean, I guess I kind of prefer shmups where you don't have that movement, where, you know, I press the joystick and I just move. But, you know, other people are fans of that. But it's definitely a game I can recommend. You know, the graphics are nice and colourful. I've never seen any slowdown or flicker. So it's not, you know, pushing the 64 beyond its limits. And sounds and music are satisfactory enough. Pretty checkable presentation, and I think we're coming up. I think we're getting close to the boss again, thankfully. I would like to be able to have another shot at it. Yeah, I guess my minor complaints, if any, is I wish the power-up system was a little more obvious. And we're here now. That's probably my only real complaint with the game, you know. It's hard to know exactly what the status of everything is at the point, especially in a way that's very easy to look at. But if it wasn't for that, I would pretty much be all over this game. And I think even now, I still am over it. That doesn't sound right, you know what I mean. I'm still for this game. I still recommend playing, checking it out. Definitely on the 64 Spectrum. I think it came out on the ST, and I think it got a release on the CPC, but no Amiga release. But overall, I despite my disappointing run, I definitely do think it's worth checking Zynaps out. And with that, I think I'm going to call it a wrap here. Thanks again for watching. If you haven't already, please do consider subscribing. I usually throw up a new game of gameplay video every week. If not, please do check out some other games. I will show some other ones that you might be worth checking out. Other than that, thanks again for watching, and I'll catch you next time.